are so silly. Hey, everybody. We're
hey
back.
Hey, everybody.
We are back with another episode of Beauty and the Beard Bedtime Stories. Thanks for joining us.
That hurts.
All right. So we're going to read a spooky book because it's almost Halloween. So you want to get the spooky book? And you have your artwork that you want to show everybody, right? You can show them whatever you want, sweet love.
Yeah, can I show them?
Yeah, I can show them it.
Ready?
Ready?
I'm gonna surprise them. Ready? Ready to turn it?
Woo! Little Miss Kate, paint. You colored these a couple days ago. Was it yesterday? No, it was last night.
Yeah.
We were watching some Halloween movies. And she was coloring, and we just had a good old time. Me and her and Big Brother. What did we watch yesterday? We watched The Haunted Mansion.
Yeah.
And we watched... Oh. We watched Ernest, Scared Stupid. If you remember the Ernest movies with Jim Varney. I watched them when I was a kid. I haven't seen them since. Almost 40 now. And, yeah, that Ernest, Scared Stupid... lives up to his name. It was not like I remember. So, anyway, Jim Varney was awesome though, you know. So, all right. So, what's our book? Let's look at our book. It's called. Let's see. It's Raining Bats and Frogs by Rebecca Colby. All right. Yeah, we got an easy last name. Woo. It's Raining Bats and Frogs by Rebecca Colby. And it's got a witch-looking critter on the front. So we're excited. We love Halloween stories.
What? Yeah.
Yeah.
I just think the witch is funny.
You think the witch is funny?
With witchy stuff.
Oh, have a kiss. Thank you. All right, here we go. It's Raining Bats and Frogs.
I popped it.
You popped your lips? Yeah, you do that sometimes. It's Raining Bats and Frogs for my parents. All right. Every year, Delia looked forward to flying in the witch parade. This year was no different, despite the black clouds hovering overhead. I think it's gonna rain, said Delia.
Delia.
That's our main character, man. Usually your main character in a story is called the protagonist. You say protagonist?
Protagonist.
Look at you. Man, I got some of my high school kids can't even say that word right. And you're 4 and you can say protagonist? Can you say antagonist?
Antagonist.
Can you say how much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
A woodchucka-chucka-chucka? I don't know how to say
it's
that.
It's okay, baby. I'm trying to trip you up. All right, here we go. It did rain hard, and the witches were wet and miserable. It's raining on our parade, one wailed. Positively pouring buckets, moaned another. That gave Delia an idea. All right, so they're out there in the rain, and they ain't having it. They're not big fans. There we go. Delia whipped out her wand and began to chant. It's raining, it's pouring, but raindrops are boring. Change the rainfall on my head. Make it cats and dogs instead. So she's out there trying to cast a spell on the rain so she can get rid of it. What do you think about that? You think she's gonna? Or you think cats and dogs are actually gonna come from the ceiling?
No.
From the ceiling. From the sky. It's like that episode of Parks and Recreation where he's like, I'll just claim this piece of floor while they're camping. Ron Swanson's like, when it's outside, it's called the ground. Maybe. I'm the only one that thinks that's funny, but ceiling and sky, I felt it was similar. Alright, nice doggy. I never met a cat I didn't like. The witchers were thrilled. At first. So look at that. She actually made it rain. Whoops, I'm sorry, darling. You okay? Oh, you okay?
That just poked
at me. It just poked at you? I'm sorry, baby. It's the edge of the book. You alright?
Mm-hmm.
Let me kiss it. You better now?
You kissed it on in my nose.
I'm sorry. All right. Gross. So we actually have cats and dogs raining down on the parade. So there we go. Right. You call this a cat? Dog, nabbit, give me my broom back. Then the parade came to an abrupt halt. This will never do, said Delia, raising her wand a second time. The raining and pouring may have been quite boring, but cats and dogs, they just don't work. They hiss and bark and go berserk. So change what's falling on my head. Make it hats and clogs instead. Please sit down so they can see you. It's supposed to be me and you reading together, baby. Not just me reading and you jumping all over the place. Sit down. Pay attention. There's going to be a quiz afterwards. All right. Black hats, my favorite. A girl can never have too many shoes. The witches were overjoyed at first, so they made hats and shoes fall down from the ceiling. From the ceiling. I said it again. From the sky. Whew.
Ceiling
fly. It's not the ceiling, it's the sky, and I messed up, and I'm sorry.
But yeah, ceiling fly. I said ceiling fly.
All right, be still, darling. That's my hat. No, it's my hat. Well, those are my shoes. I saw them first. Then the parade erupted into a free-for-all. Delia sighed. What a big to-do, she said, waving her wand again. The raining and pouring may have been quite boring, but hats and clogs just have to go, inciting fights, creating woe. So change what's falling on my head. Make it bats and frogs instead. Man, she's changing it again. Wow. Snack time, girls. Somebody grab a cauldron. The witches were ecstatic at first. So you got frogs and bats just falling down from the sky. That's crazy, huh? Mm-hmm. Are you paying attention?
Yeah.
You sure? Mm-hmm. You sure?
Yeah.
You promise?
Yeah. My dad said something.
I've been slimed. I don't think that's slime. Ooh. Sounds like a poop joke. But then the witches became even more wet and miserable than before. What should we do now? Worried Delia. Delia had run out of ideas. Gnats and bogs, she mumbled to herself. Mats and logs, rats and hogs. There's her thinking of different things she could replace the bats and frogs with. Alright, the more Delia thought about it, the more she realized there was only one thing to do. With that, she raised her wand one last time and chanted, the raining and pouring wasn't really boring, and bats and frogs just make a mess. They drop and plop and cause distress, so change what's falling on my head back to drops of rain instead. So she finally got fed up. She's like, hey, you know what? Bring back the rain. That wasn't so terrible.
What?
What?
Why do we have to bring back the rain?
That's because all the other stuff was causing madness, and she didn't like it. Thank goodness, it's only water. The witches were relieved. The parade soon proceeded. A little rain never hurt anyone, and the longer it rained, the more exciting the parade became. So now it's raining again, and they seem like they're pretty happy about it. So that's cool.
It's because they have hats on, and they're not getting their head wet.
Yeah, you got a hat on, you don't get your head wet. The floats began to float. The marching band learned synchronized swimming. So they're all out there learning how to make it happen in the rain.
Your dad was done over my princess to sleep.
You wear your princess dress to sleep?
Yeah.
Man, didn't you wear that dress last night?
No.
Or maybe we filmed two videos in one day. Movie magic. And Delia and her friends tossed water balloons into the crowd. Everyone agreed it was the best parade ever. Catherine, be still, darling. Sheesh. All right, so there we go. The parade's actually going off without a hitch now. Are you going to sleep?
I'm just tired.
You're tired? Well, let's go to bed. We don't even have to finish the book. We need to go to bed right now.
No.
Why?
Because
If you're that tired and you can't even finish the book with me, then we'll just go to bed.
No, I won't.
No.
I won't close my eyes when I'm sleeping.
Okay. So, everyone agreed it was the best parade ever. Until the year that it snowed. Wah, wah, wah. So, that looks like the end. So, she was all bent out of shape about the rain, and then she finally got it back to the rain, and everybody was happy. Now they're saying it snowed. So, that's what we in the business call a cliffhanger. Because I think there might be a follow-up book. We'll have to look if we can find another one. That might be cool. So, again, this is It's Raining Bats and Frogs by Rebecca Colby. I thought that was kind of cool. The illustrations are pretty neat, too. It's got like a... It's Halloween type story, but it, I don't know. I like the artwork. It's got kind of a simple elegance to it. Very cool. Illustrated by Stephen Henry. So, that works out. All right. Well, that was another great story in the books. So, we need to tell them good night, and thanks for watching Beauty and the Beard, and we'll see you next time. Tell them.
Bye.
No, tell them the other part. Tell them what I just said.
Sit up. Tonight from Beauty and the Beard.
There we go. Was that so hard?
No.
No? All right. Good night. Good night, everybody.
Bye.
Leave your old jalopy by the railroad track.